dare because it's something that I've never done. It was a new experience for me. You know, I wouldn't have got to do my formal because I left school and that, so it'd be really awesome to do my dare.
This was an opportunity for kids to realise that they can go out into community and have a good night and still go home in that positive light that they had while they were there. They need something to look forward to as much as anybody else, and it gave them the self-confidence on the day to be able to look at themselves in the mirror and say, yeah, I'm all right. You know, I'm doing all right. I'm going somewhere in my life. They all worked well together. The dance practice was probably one of the hardest things to organise. The parents were all teary. Even I got teary through the dance practice.
I love dressing up and that in the dresses. I really love my dress. The dresses we're wearing, most of them were really expensive dresses. So I was like, I feel really special that I'm wearing this dress right now. I loved doing the hair and all that, getting my makeup done.
All the dresses were donated, the hair was donated, makeup was donated.
And that, like, people actually had all eyes on you and was like, oh, you were the star of the night. Like, that was pretty cool.
The girls looked absolutely beautiful, all in their white dresses and their gloves and all their accessories that they accessorised themselves with. It's probably hard enough to dance in heels, but to do that with a long gown and that without tripping over and there are twirls and quick steps and all that, I think they looked elegant the whole night. And all the men looked absolutely handsome with their all suited up all the same. And they took pride in their presence, like all the men were clean shaven and their hair was done that, always smiling. I feel like a proud parent just because I was the oldest one there, so.
I have never seen any of the boys dress up like that. They looked so good, I was like, whoa. I was really surprised at how good they turned out. They were really rocking them. I was like, oh, they look like penguins in their little penguin suits because the little things at the back, but it was so funny. There was a few couples there on the night, so it was kind of cute to see them because I think it's something that they'll remember as well. If you love someone and you've done something like this, which is a special moment you shared together, it's like, kind of like, ah, he's cute. And they're like, oh, getting all embarrassed.
I was just proud to see all of them. They all look so great and I think they all had a good night, so, and to see the parents being involved.
One of the great things about the night was the generations. Like, of course all the devs were all young, I think not one of them was over the age of 20, and then you had their parents' generation and then the grandparents' the generation as well. When the Debs got introduced, a little biography got read about them, just basically their clan groups and then what their interests are and things like that. And as they're walking out, there were two elders that were seated at the end of the aisle, you could say. The elders would definitely know these young people or their families and would have seen them grow up. I was kind of peeking through the door as they were walking down, and the two delegates were just smiles from ear to ear every time each Deb got brought out.
Dancing with elders, it was good to see everyone else, you know, having a ball and the elders having a laugh. So I danced with my pop, but he loved it.
Like when it was time for the mother and father dance or people got up their grandparents or whatever, I think that they feel very blessed to have seen such strong young men and women in the community, in the Indigenous community. I can't speak for everyone, but I got a little bit nervous leading up to it, because you see all the people that are funded it out there, so you know that you want to put on a good show for them so that they feel appreciative of where their money's going and hopefully do more of these things, which would be really amazing. But also, you've got your parents and your grandparents and your aunts and uncles, and as well as all your Deb colleagues that you've been working with for about 2 months of rehearsals or something, being the eldest one to participate in there. It's a little bit kind of nerve-wracking because you've got to like kind of show a little bit of leadership as well without trying to lose yourself in the silliness with all the young ones, that you can't help it because it's just so fun, which is why I thank the Deb and the Youth Foundation 381 for putting on this event and allowing me to be a part of it and help these young people mould into young men and women and leaders of the community.